You're watching Adorama TV.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Adorama TV. I'm Mark Wallace. Well, this week's iPad app review is all about Celtx Script. Now, we've talked a little bit about Celtx Studios and Celtx for the Macintosh and PC. It's a desktop application. Well, now some of that functionality comes to the iPad as well as the iPhone. So we're going to take a look really quickly at Celtx Script. Celtx Script is an application on the iPad that allows you to write screenplays, but it also allows you to interface with Celtx Studios, which is a free application for your desktop. So this, as I open it up, we have a sample script in here. This is the Wizard of Oz, and you can see that we have all kinds of things in here. We have scene headings, we have action, we have characters, we have dialogue, etc. So let's go in here and let's create our own script. So I'm going to hit this script button right here, and I'm going to push the plus button, and it's going to ask me for my script name. I'll just call it test, and then it's going to ask who wrote this, and I'll say Mark did. Okay, Mark did it. And then this other thing here, Celtx Sync. Now you want to turn that on if you have Celtx Studio or Celtx for your desktop application. So I'm going to say done, and now I have this test script. I can go in here. The first thing it's going to ask me for is my scene heading. So this menu bar at the top, it has a scene heading. This is for action. This is for your characters. If you want to add dialogue, you put that in there. For a parenthetical, you have that. And then of course you have your shots and your transitions. So it's just like any screenwriting software that you would normally have. So for example, I can say this is an interior shot and it's at an office. So there we go. Now as soon as I hit return, it's going to go straight to action, which is what we would expect. And I'm going to say Leon is hiding. He's hiding in the corner. So that sort of sets the scene, and of course I could type in a bunch of stuff. I'll hit return. Now it's asking for more action, but I want to enter a character, so I'll tap that and I'll say Leon, that's my character. And so then as soon as I hit return, that automatically goes to dialogue, and I'll have Leon say something and say, I don't know, hi there. I don't know why he's hiding, but you know, I'm not a very good writer. Hi there. And then I'll say a little parenthetical here. Leon sneaks a Snickers because he loves candy. I don't know. I'm just making stuff up. And then I can go in here and I can say, you know, this is a wide shot. And I'll go back here, add some more action. Leon runs across room. You can see this is becoming really horrible. So anyway, etc. You can do all kinds of stuff. And then let's say we need to transition that to, so that automatically made that transition. I'll go back here to make this action. I'll hit return. I'll make this fade to black. Okay, there we go. Now I have my horrible script in here of Leon running across the room, and I am done. Okay, I've written my script. There it is. So I've got all my different things set up. Now if I go back to script, and I'm going to hit sync. Now when I do that, you're going to see something else. I've previously exported a script that I built on my desktop machine, and you're going to see that show up here, but this is also going to save this test to the server, so when I open my desktop machine, I can import that as well. So I'm going to hit sync. This is going to go out, contact the server. It's going to bring everything in. So when I go back, you can see that test has been saved to the server, and then also this other script that I created earlier has been brought in. So that was one I exported from my desktop. Now, let me show you how to export. So this is the Digital Photography One-on-One White Balance that I did a few weeks ago, I guess, on Adorama TV. But let me go quickly and show you how you export from your desktop. It's pretty simple. You just go to the Script menu, you click Script, and then Export to your iPad or iPhone. Now, once you do that, then when you sync, you'll see that that shows up here. All right, now that we've synced, you can see that this Digital Photography One-on-One White Balance episode is here, and I can look through that, and you can see all of the, this is a very, very basic script, but I have that in there. Now the nice thing is, if I click this over here, I can see all of my different scene headings. So if I just need to jump to the wrap-up at the studio, I can see that, or if I need to go to the animation to see what I'm supposed to read, I can do that. So this is really, really nice. If you're reading through a script and you have a really long script, you can see those. So let me look, show you a little bit more complicated script. And this was a studio lighting DVD that I'm working on. So this has many, many scenes. In fact, it's got right now 42 scenes. It'll probably have more than that by the end of it. But let's say we're shooting on location and I need to know, well, what is scene 9? What is that all about? I can just hit that, go through there and see, oh, okay, that's exactly what we're talking about. How does that roll into 10? Okay, got it. Now let's go back to 5. So this is really nice because most of the time you don't shoot in sequence. And so to get some context to see what's going on, that's there. So it's really, really nice. Now the other thing is I have this test script. And so if I have this here, what I can do is let me show you how you import that into the Celtx on your desktop. Now it's just the opposite of what you did when you exported it. You just go to Script, Import from iPad or iPhone, and we can see that this script looks just like it did on the iPad, and now I can do all kinds of other things in my desktop application, like doing my master catalog and scheduling and things like that. It's very, really, really nice. Well, that's Celtx Script for the iPad. Now, a couple things that you should be aware of before you purchase this application. First of all, the sync that we showed you, the sync functionality, well, that does not work with Celtx Studios. So if you have a story or a script that you've saved to Celtx Studios and you want to sync it right to your iPad, it doesn't work. You have to actually go to a desktop application, open it from Celtx Studios, and then export it to the iPad. Now that's a bummer because if you're working in a collaborative environment, which most people do, if somebody else updates the script in Celtx Studios, well, it doesn't automatically show up in the iPad. You have to, again, go to the desktop, export it, and then it'll show up there. The other thing that the sync does not work with, it does not work for AV scripts, it doesn't work for storyboards, and it doesn't work for sketches either. And I really hope that Celtx updates their application because those are really, really valuable tools that we use a lot. Also, the production catalog and scheduling, that isn't available either. This only works for your scripts. Well, based on that, I still think this is a really, really valuable tool for anybody that's using Celtx because what you can go in and you can use these for read-throughs, you can use them to make sure that you're getting all of your stuff done on location, and if you just really need to look at your lines as an actor, you can just scroll through here and see what you're doing. So it's worth the 10 bucks for this application, and I do recommend it if you're a heavy user of Celtx. Well, there you have it. Thanks for joining us this week at Adorama TV. Remember, if you have a question about iPad apps, you can send those to me at askmark@adorama.com. Well, thanks for joining us. I'll see you next week.
This episode is brought to you by Adorama TV. Visit the Adorama Learning Center, where you'll find photography tips and techniques, links to the gear used in this episode, and related videos. For all the latest photography, video, and computer gear, visit adorama.com. And the next time you're in New York City, visit our store located on 18th Street between 5th and 6th Avenue.